I need you to keep an eye out for Roderick.
As his father, I could not be more proud of the man he's become.
To be done with you. It's been on my mind for a while now. Something must be done.
With me, my lord?
You've served House Forrester well for several years now, but I can't expect you to squire forever. How shall I reward your...
There were
those who had their doubts when your uncle put forth your name as my squire. But you've erased those doubts entirely. It would be an honor to see you riding by Roderick's side in the vanguard tomorrow. Not as a squire, but as the equal of any man who serves House Forrester. It's well deserved, Garrett.
So I'm no longer a squire?
As of tomorrow, no. But for now, keep this between us. We're celebrating tonight, and I wouldn't want the other squires to feel discouraged.
Yes, my lord.
Now go, and find Roderick if you can.
I will, my lord. Thank you.
Bloody hell.
Empty. Squire! Fetch us more wine!
Can you give me a hand? Come on. Can I get up to you?
Yeah, no problem.
I have been a squire longer than you.
So?
I outrank you. You should help me. Fetch more wine, scrub my armor, clean my boots. Just my luck to end up with Norin while you serve the Lord. Let him fetch his own wine for once. He's a drunk, a liar, and an arrogant prick.
You'd better watch your tongue, Bowen. It could be much worse.
What the fuck do you know about it? Nothing is worse than Norin.
See, that's where you're lucky. Low expectations. If I'd grown up covered in pig shit, shovel and slop...
Pig farmers. All I'm saying is, at this rate we'll never be more than this, which is nothing. The lowest of the low. For all I know, we could be squires for life.
Hauling wine around a fucking wedding. Give it time. You'll get there.
Or easy for you to say. Maybe if my uncle were castellan at House Forrester, I'd feel different.
Who my uncle is has nothing to do with it. How much further?
It's right over there.
Take your time.
You lot have drunk your share. Good thing Lord Walder's in a generous mood.
Fucking phrase.
Nice night for a wedding. Not often he finds a willing husband for one of his daughters.
Don't expect me to carry it for you, Sir Garrett. What? What's wrong? What's gone into you? You're acting rather odd.
We need to get back. Now.
They're fine, they can wait.
No, you don't understand. We need to go.
And take the fucking flagon already.
What's wrong with him? Something the matter?
Bowen, we have to go.
You go if you're in such a rush.
We have to warn the others.
Good luck.
Run!
Ready, boys! Whoa! Shoot that one!
My lord.
Where's my squire? You didn't leave him, did you?
What happened to him?
I didn't leave him. But I couldn't save him.
Find a weapon, quickly!
Still time.
Seven hells.
You're wounded, my lord.
I've suffered worse.
Walder Frey says time. Don't
this with your life. Return it to Ironrath, where it belongs. There's no time to waste. I'll be damned if I let it fall into the hands of those traitors. You have to go.
I will do as you command, my lord.
You have served me well. I know I can count on you. Tell your uncle. Tell him. The North Grove must never be lost. Tell no one but him. Do you understand? You must swear. Tell only your uncle Duncan.
I swear that I will, my lord.
Hey, it's those foresters!
On your honor, you must do this for your house. Go!
Kill those fucking foresters!
With love,
free!
Blood.
Fresh. That's Father's car.
Lord Bolton better give us fucking titles for this.
Victor may be coming, but at least he'll have his bacon.
Move along, boy. There's nothing for you here.
Father.
I said move on.
I'm going to kill you.
Is that so? You can try if you like.
And then we'll feed you to the pigs.
Get off my land!
This is Bolton land now, boy. Lord Bolton is the new warden of the North. I reckon he'd like a proper lordly sword like that.
I'll have that sword, boy.
Fuck you.
All right. Finish this fucking pig farmer.
Pathetic.
You are a pig.
For this. That much I promise.
Father?
Garrett, you survived. Your sister. Oh, she hid. I tried to stop them.
I'll kill the men who did this.
It's Garrett! Get the Castellan! Tell him his nephew survived!
Garrett!
I was too late. They were already dead.
Bring the Maester! Meet us in the Great Hall! Quickly!
Two White Hill soldiers?
And a Bolton. They killed my family. And for what? My sister, she was only 8 years old.
This never would have happened with the Starks in power. It's unimaginable. Unacceptable. You have my condolences.
Thank you, Maester.
The blade cut deep, but I should be able to save your leg.
Your justice was swift.
Some will call it vengeance. No doubt the Whitehills will claim it was murder. It was your family. I can't say I would have done any different than you.
I'd do it again if I had the chance.
If we don't respond with strength, they won't stop until they have everything. These maggots ought to help prevent infection. Hold the wound open for me, would you? These are dark days, I fear. To lose the Lord of the House and the eldest son through such a despicable act of treachery and betrayal. Greater houses than ours have fallen in times such as this. The late Lord Forrester was a good man. And poor Roderick. A serious man, but he would have made a good lord.
Our house will never fall.
By the gods, let's hope you're right. The future of this house is in Lord Ethan's hands now, although he is young and altogether unprepared to lead. Right. This might hurt a bit. Hold this for me, will you? I understand from your uncle that Lord Forrester saved your life.
He did.
Rather odd, though, that he chose to save you, his squire, and not his son, Roderick. Not that Roderick couldn't handle himself. He's as good with a sword as any man I've seen. That's Lady Forrester. We'll be here any moment now. I'd like you to walk for me first, to see if you can put any weight on that leg. Go on. Don't stop now. It's better to let the blood circulate.
The Ironwood Grove. An ironwood shield.
The strongest wood in the known world. You seem to be favoring it. Always sad to see a warrior lose a leg.
I'm fine, Maester Ortengren. Look, I'll show you.
Did your leg feel weak?
No. I just wanted to ask you. Who is the new lord of House Forrester?
Why, Ethan, of course. At the Citadel, I swore an oath to serve whichever noble house I was assigned. Advising the late Lord Forrester was an honor. Advising Ethan, his third-born son, is challenging. There's still so much he has to learn, yet the very fate and future of this house rests in his hands. Which is rather frightening when you think about it.
What will happen to me now?
Excellent question. Under normal circumstances, you could join Sir Roiland and his men. Although, given the circumstances of your... circumstances, it becomes a bit tricky, doesn't it? I suppose it will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
Lord Forrester promoted me. At the Twins, I'm no longer a squire, if that matters.
It might, I suppose. But I'll defer to Lord Ethan on this.
Can I see Ethan? Is he here?
He is, but I'm afraid he's indisposed at the moment. He prefers not to be disturbed while practicing his lute.
Can I go now?
I believe your leg will be fine. Only time will tell, but... Lady Forrester.
Welcome home, Garrett. We're all relieved to know you survived.
Thank you, my lady.
Talia asked to see you.
Garrett, I heard what happened. Is it true? Your family... I'm so sorry.
Mato.
Off to bed now. Hurry on. Garrett was just telling me how valiantly Lord Forrester fought to the end. Even when all was lost. I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know.
He saved my life, my lady.
Yet not Roderick's.
You were with Roderick, no? I'm sure it was chaos and confusion. But if you can remember anything...
Robb Stark named him to lead the van for the march on Casterly Rock.
A fitting tribute, no doubt. He was House Forrester's best.
This has been so incredibly difficult for us, especially the children. But I was told you were the last to see my husband alive.
Yes, my lady.
I know it may be difficult to remember, but if I may ask, was there anything he said?
Any last words before he passed, if you can remember?
He asked me to return this to House Forrester. He said this is where it belongs, with his family.
Thank you. Garrett.
Of course, my lady.
It demands a response.
It's too dangerous, especially now.
Now is the time to prove our strength.
I'll be sure it's given to Ethan.
Duncan, this was our land. They were our people. Your family.
I share your outrage, Sir Roiland. I do. But now is not the time to provoke the White Hills. Not with Ramsay Snow coming to see us bend the knee.
The hell with Ramsay Snow, the bastard.
Garrett, you understand what this means. You killed a Bolton, and Ramsay Snow will want his retribution.
We're the ones that should be demanding retribution.
They attacked me.
And they'll say they were keeping the peace in the name of House Bolton. It's an argument you cannot win. We have to be smart. Ramsay Snow will be here within the week.
And what would you have us do? Nothing.
I would have us use our heads, while they're still attached to our shoulders.
Garrett has lost as much as anyone else within these walls. Maybe you can talk some sense into your uncle.
Garrett's suffered enough already. You ask too much of the boy.
He deserves to be heard.
They deserve to die. All of them. I say we fight.
Ha! Listen to your nephew. He speaks sense.
With what army? Our best men were killed at the Twins, along with our lord.
Then what's to be done?
Ultimately, it will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
He's just a boy who can barely hold a sword. He knows nothing of how to lead men.
He is the lord of this house, and he needs our help. It's bad enough the Boltons would have us bend the knee and swear fealty. But now, this. But... I'll accuse you of murder, and us of protecting you.
The boy was just defending himself.
I'm not faulting him for what he did.
It wasn't murder. It was justice.
Not in their eyes. It's just the excuse Ramsay Snow would need to put us to the torch and kill us all.
I'd like to see them try.
I'm afraid it's a risk we cannot take, which is why you cannot stay.
Cannot stay?
But where would I go?
The one place beyond the reach of even House Bolton.
You're sending him to the wall? The boy's done nothing wrong.
Not in the eyes of the Boltons. I'm afraid it's the only solution. Especially now, when the house is so vulnerable.
I'll do what's best for the house. So I'll go. I'm not afraid.
I know it doesn't seem fair, but it is what's best.
That settles it, then. You can have my horse.
And I'll see you have plenty of food. But we haven't much time. The White Hills will come looking for you. Word up to me. I'd gladly drive a sword through Lord Whitehill's heart if given a chance. I would. And God's willing, someday, I will. But for now, I have House Forrester to consider first. Lord Forrester would be proud that you're putting the interests of the house ahead of your own. Many of Lord Forrester's best men have volunteered for the war. His own great-uncle was a ranger with the Night's Watch.
He promoted me. At the Twins. We were to ride in the van to Casterly Rock, and I at Roderick's side, but...
It was well-deserved, Garrett. You worked hard and served your lord with honour.
Lord Forrester. Asked me to give you a message. He said, "The North Grove can never be lost."
Sorry, you caught me by surprise. It's not often discussed, if ever.
He said tell only you.
For good reason. Most don't even know it exists. They think it's just a myth made up by wildlings and fools, and it's better kept that way.
I assume you kept your word.
You haven't told anyone else, have you? This is important, Garrett.
Of course not. I told no one.
Well done. Lord Forrester was right to put his trust in you. From this day forward, this will be our secret. But soon, I may need your help.
But
I can't say anything more just yet. Just know the North Grove may very well be vital to the future of this house. But don't breathe a word of it to anyone at the wall. Become a ranger if you can. It will help. Iron from ice.
Iron from ice.
Remember, you represent House Forrester. Your actions at the war will reflect the honor and dignity of the house.
I'll make you proud.
You already have.
Wait! Be safe.
Find him.
could you? He hides too well, and if he were smart, he would reveal himself.
I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
I win!
Congratulations, your lordship.
Don't worry. It's just a game, Ryan.
A stupid game. I don't like it.
He was worried you were gone.
I thought we'd never find you again.
I'm right here. And I promise, I'm not going anywhere.
I wish Mira was here. And Asha. And Roderick.
I do too. But Mira's in King's Landing and...
Can't she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Ryan, she's perfectly safe, I promise you.
I don't want Garrett to die either. Maester Ortengren said he got sent to the Wall. I'll miss Garrett. He was nice.
Garrett is strong. He can take care of himself.
No one will tell me what Garrett did, but it must have been serious. I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland talking. They said someone will come here looking for revenge.
Everyone's worried about you, but I'm not. I know you'll protect us.
Who said they're worried about me?
Well, Sir Roiland for one. He says you can't fight very well.
What?
And he calls you a milksop.
Sir Roiland forgets himself.
He doesn't know me or what I'm capable of.
What does milksop mean?
I don't know, but I know it's not good.
Ethan, you should let Sir Roiland teach you how to wield a sword, like a man. He taught Roderick and Asha, and he even showed me how to fight. Properly, I mean.
A lord should know how to fight.
Do you remember when we were younger? When we all used to play here? You, me, Roderick, Asha. We'd all be out here for hours.
Yeah. Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
We had so much fun. But then, well, then everything changed. Roderick became so serious, the lord in training, and he never smiled anymore. And Asha just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are. I know a lord has many responsibilities.
I promise I won't change.
Good, because I'd rather have a brother than a lord.
I'll have to have both, I'm afraid.
But since you're the new lord, you can do anything you want.
I suppose.
Everyone will have to do as you say. So I could have all the sweets I want.
If only it were that simple.
As many as you'd like, yes.
Really?
Of course. Why not?
Lord Ethan, you're needed in the Great Hall at once. Quickly, on your feet.
What's the matter?
Lord Whitehill has arrived, unannounced and certainly unexpected. He's come demanding justice.
Can't he meet with Duncan? He is the Castellan.
Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
He's demanding an audience with the Lord. We really must go.
It's your decision. You are the Lord.
If I were Lord, I would command Ethan to stay. With his family. Lord Whitehill is a mean old man anyways.
Fine. If that's what's required of me.
Very well, then.